This is my name is Billy Joe. This is Mike, and this is Trey Cool. And we're here to induct Guns N' Roses into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The first time I saw Guns N' Roses on MTV, I thought one of these guys could end up dead or in jail. The opening riff of Welcome to the Jungle is a descending trip into the underworld of Los Angeles. This ride was not about parties, glamour, or power ballads. It was about the seedy underworld of misfits, drug addicts, paranoia, sex, violence, love, and anger in the cracks of Hollywood. It was a breath of fresh air. Needless to say, I bought the record. Appetite for Destruction is the best debut album in the history of rock and roll. Steven Adler, you're drumming. Your drumming on Appetite for Destruction was perfect. It was like the perfect combination between slamming hard rock songs and laying into a great groove. It's fucking unbelievable, man. Great. Matt Sorum. You took over seamlessly. You brought in new dynamics and power. And your first gig was Rockin' Rio. Welcome to the band. Dizzy Reed, you play a mean keyboard. Keep up with the good job. Duff McKagan. The Seattle transplant punk rock kid. You're like Johnny Thunders with a bass. The bass line to Sweet Child of Mine is so good you can sing along to it. And you're in a band called The Farts. Izzy Stradlin. Wherever you are, the way you played and weaved with Slash was an effortless craft. You got that fucking Ronnie Wood mojo, I'll tell you that right now. Slash. While every guitar geek in LA was riding on the coattails of Eddie Van Halen, you took a totally different approach. You bridged the gap between Eric Clapton, Jimmy Page, and Joe Perry, and you brought it into your own modern era. I can immediately identify your leads and riffs because you embody them. Your guitar playing is an extension of your heart and soul. To see you without a guitar and a top hat is just plain weird. And let's see, who am I missing? I don't know.
Whoa.
Easy. What's up? You know what? No, shut the fuck up. Shut up. This man's a badass fucking singer. He's one of the best frontmen to ever touch a microphone. Your lyrics are heartfelt, passionate, angry, and you tell the truth no matter what the cost. Your vocal range goes from a quiet whisper to a powerhouse until you're screaming bloody murder.
And you're fucking crazy.
And Hey, most singers are crazy. I can vouch for that right now. But you know, I mean, being in a band is it's a very complex thing. You go through eras and chapters of your life. But sometimes you gotta look back at the old chapters if you wanna move forward. And the reason why you have to look backwards is to know where you fucking come from. Ladies and gentlemen, Guns N' Roses.
I'm Duff McKagan. Hello, Cleveland! I'm so honored to have met these guys in those rank back alleys in Hollywood. And we learned how to write songs together. And we created brutality and beauty and told the truth all at once, but we were writing these songs for ourselves. We had no audience. And we played our first gigs, and suddenly we had people showing up to see us play. As we progressed, more and more fans came, and they were relating to these songs. I don't know if they were relating to us so much, but the songs spoke to them. And I don't know if it matters who's here tonight, because it's about the music that band created. I'd like to thank our original road crew, Mick Bob, Mike Mayhew, Tom Mayhew and Adam Day, and Mike Klink for capturing our sound on Appetite for Destruction and the Illusions Records. But we're here, and I want this to be heard. We're here because we're overwhelmed. I am personally overwhelmed by you fans and the reaction when we were nominated for this thing around the fucking world. I honor you. Thank you.
Hi guys, I'm Steven Adler. I play drums and a cowbell.
Oh mama.
I wanna just thank a couple people, Tom Zutat, Teresa Ensenat, Vicki Hamilton, and Mike Klink. I want to thank them for giving us the opportunity and a chance and believed in us and didn't want to change us and just let us be ourselves. And that was fucking cool. And it worked. All right, I want to leave you with the words of the late, great Freddie Mercury. I've taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. And I thank you all.
Thank you. Don't make this any harder. I'm terrible with speeches. All right. But I do want to thank the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame for this acknowledgement. But yeah, most importantly, I want to thank the fans, because the fans are the ones that made it possible for us to get together tonight. The fans have been there since the beginning. We've got new fans that have never seen the original lineup, and they're still rooting for us. But I also want to take a second. I gotta give credit where credit's due. I gotta thank my wife as well, because when all the drama was going on, I started to succumb to, like, you know what, fuck it. She said, you know, just go do it for the fans. And I said, you know what, you're right. So I gotta give her credit. And then, also, I wanna mention a couple people who were really responsible for taking this derelict, fucked up, dysfunctional band and seeing something in it and going to the mat to get us signed and get us out there. And that was Tom Zutat and
Teresa Ensenat from Geffen Records. Early on, it was Vicki Hamilton who tried to manage us with all her heart. And ultimately, Alan Niven, who was the guy who was really the one that helped pull it all together and get us out there. We became the band that was born to lose that actually made it. So I want to thank all of them. But thank you all, and let's go play.
That's more than I've ever heard Slash talk in his entire life. I was originally in a band called The Cult. When these two knuckleheads showed up at a gig, Slash and Duff, as a joke, I said to my girlfriend at the time, I said, hey, maybe I could play with those guys someday. And I'm at my mom's house, because at the time I had no money, and I was basically a vagabond, sleeping on couches and things. But I got a call from this guy. My mom comes to my room. She says, there's a guy on the phone named Swash or Slush. Or... So I pick up the phone, and he says, Matt, this is Slash. And I'm like, yeah, what's up? He says, we had to kick our drummer out for doing too many drugs. I said, how the fuck is that possible in Guns N' Roses? You know, all I wanted was to play in a rock and roll band, and now I'm at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That is just fucking crazy. Thank you very much, and thank you to the fans. We love you.
Mr. Miles Kennedy on vocals.
Gilby Clark on guitar.